Hi, this is Ian Anderson of Jethro Tull, and we're going to think about the climate change issues for the climate edition of Rolling Stone. This is a very interdependent issue when we think about it, especially in the context of today's world in the middle of a true pandemic crisis. Everything depends on everything else. It's the issues of population growth, of globalization, of economic expeditionary forces around the world trying to make more out of less. And of course, the issues of climate change are also dependent on our dependence on travel, our dependence on fossil fuels and the carbon footprint that comes from unabashed use of resources, which are very limited. What am I doing to address the issues of climate change? Well, it goes back a long way, back in 1973, when I wrote my first song about climate change, skating away on the thin ice of the new day on the War Child album.
But those who choose to stay will live just one more day to do the things they should have done.
Of course, at that time, scientists or popular scientific opinion was that we were potentially moving towards a period of global cooling, another ice age. They got it wrong. However, the point was made, and even before that, I wrote a song called Locomotive Breath, which is about the runaway train of population growth and expansion around the world. So, you know, I've been thinking about these things since I was almost a kid. But today's world is a little bit different. 15 years ago, we planted 30,000 trees, hardwood species native to this part of the world, here on the farm in the southwest of England. This year, we plant another 10,000 trees, and you might be forgiven for thinking that I'm in carbon credit right now, which technically I suppose I am by a considerable margin in spite of all my international travel to go to work. But it would be so much better if we lived in a world where I didn't have to travel to go to work. And we have to get used to the idea that we don't need to travel as much as we have taken advantage of doing in the past. We don't need to depend on personalized transport. You see, I'm a public transport guy. I don't even have a driving license. I use the train, I use the bus. I share a lift with several other people if we're going in a big van or in a bus. That's very hard right now in the midst of a pandemic crisis because, of course, public transport is the last thing that I'm going to do, even if I was able to do it since we've had so many flights cancelled in the last few weeks. So times are changing. Maybe we're going to look back on all of this in a year or so and think, in spite of the inevitable deaths and the ill health and the infection rates rising day by day, maybe this period is going to be a period that teaches us something. Teaches us, perhaps, that there is an easier and simpler way of life if we break free of those shackles, of that perceived need to travel to exotic places, to use personal transport, to consume so much meat, whether it's animal welfare or your own health is at stake. That is another major issue in terms of climate change. You know, I am more or less a vegetarian. I eat fish and some bivalves from time to time, but I don't really do meat and haven't done for a while for a number of reasons. However, it's all up to you. I mean, you're a bunch of old hippies. You shouldn't find this too difficult. Stay safe, be well. Hope to see you in a year or two.